The path, the master path, there's this one saying, you've all heard me say it, except those that haven't. Reformers want it. See? And most people, yeah, I want to be a reformer. I want to be a spiritual activist. Just, Gary, where should I go? I'll reform these people, though. So the saying is, reformers want it, not of others, but of yourself. We're into working with ourselves, and that's a huge distinction. Your entire lifetime will be taken up with just working with your own consciousness. So many limitations and dark corners exist in the folds of our consciousness, and you'd be surprised. And sometimes it can even take more than a lifetime to actually discover who we are in spirit and soul. Now contrast that, I'm not down on the church, but contrast that concept to walking into a church for a half hour, accepting Jesus Christ and feeling as though you've been saved from all your sins and you're going to heaven. See, that's what I call instant salvation, and there's no such thing. In the minds of the religious devotees, it's a real thing, but it's an illusion. No, you've got to work on your salvation. And so to the new seekers, I want to tell you that the law of karma and reincarnation are an integral part of the teachings. No God-man or Messiah or Savior comes swooshing down into your life and just wipes your karmatic or sinful chart clean. That's not how it works. You were born in this lifetime based on your past lifetime's karma. Everything that we do is an effect of previous causes. If you've got a bad life, you are the one that punished yourself. If you've got a moderate or good life, you were the one that rewarded yourself by your past lifetime's actions. The whole purpose of creation down here in the lower worlds is to deal with our karmic slate, rectify those areas that are Maya-ridden and illusory, discover our true self, and rise out of the world to duality. Some can do it in one lifetime, some it takes two. Those that are dragging from up from behind sometimes can take three. Just to pull off self-realization, to liquidate the karmic account and discover ourself and God beings within us. For the new seekers, ask the spirit within you. Every one of you has a spirit and a soul. Even if you don't know about it, you got one anyway. You couldn't be alive if you didn't have a soul and the sound current within you. Everyone has it, period. Ask that power, even if you can't conceptualize or envision it, ask it. You new seekers that are doubtful and wondering what's going on, ask for it to show you if you're on the right path or not. Just ask it. You don't know what's going to happen, what's going to come down, but ask your own spirit to give you some help in order to assist you in determining whether the stuff I've been telling you up here deserves further investigation. Ask for some help. Now, you don't have to. I am just assuming you're spiritual seekers. I have to. I assume that you want whatever spirituality is, whatever it might be, you have a draw to it. Most evolved souls do. They can't tell you what it is. There's too many people trying to define it for you. Ministers, priests, gurus, stuff like this. But if you ask your own inner self, even if you don't know what it is, please help me, guide me. Show me if MasterPath has any value in it. Show me if anything, a dream, an outer experience, some passage in a book, some unique experience that happens to you where your life is saved, and you know it was from this power, ask and you shall receive. Ask and it shall be given to you. So you don't trust me. I'm just up here being a mouthpiece. But you can trust your own inner guidance. And so I'm urging you, for those that are interested, consult it and see what happens. Just be open-minded, okay? And whether this takes a day or a year to find out if this path is for you or not, it doesn't make any difference. Don't be rushed. Take your time. We got eternity, and I really mean that in a good way. There's no rush. All of life's about finding God, spirit, and self. That's all it's about. That's the purpose and objective of life. So we're given full amount of time to pull this off. And if you knew how long we've all been here, you wouldn't believe me. It's been a long, long time. It's been a long time. We've come up from the very gases and one-celled beings, amoebas. We've gone through the mineral kingdom. We've gone through the plant and the fish and the amphibian and the birds and the animal kingdom. And we find ourselves now in the human body. This is the highest body on this physical plane. It's the apex of creation. And it's through this physical body that we are to discover spirit, soul, and God. This is why we're given the human body. We're not given the human body to raise families, have babies, and make love. We're given it to find out who we really are, our true divinity. Okay.